celebration of the publication of a Festschrift titled Explorations in Management Thought, written in honor of our dear Professor Ishwarya. For those who don't know me, I'm Frida Swaminathan. I'm an alumni of the IMA 1977 batch. We're almost as good as the 71 batch. Consulting with both the corporate and the academic world, I'm very happy to be anchoring this program. Just one little administrative task I have, which if I may request everybody to turn their mobiles to a silent mode so that the evening can go on. Thank you very much. How does one acknowledge the many contributions done by a maestro in a short evening like this? We cannot do full justice, but we can definitely try. This is indeed a special evening where we are together for a single purpose, to honor a great professional for his lifetime contributions in the field of management development. In fact, honor and recognition, my dear friends, is a very inherent part of our culture. I think in some communities, a person's 80th birthday is celebrated in a big way because usually he has seen 100 moons. Thousand moons, yeah. Honor and academics in the field of management comes with a rigor of hard work, strategic thinking, focused research, and academic merit. Dr. D.V. Kapoor will now celebrate these contributions of Professor Dayal with the presentation of the Festschrift. Let me say a few words about Dr. D.V. Kapoor. Dr. D.V. Kapoor needs no introduction to management professionals. He was the founder, chairman, and managing director of NTPC. Described as a model manager by the World Bank, Dr. Kapoor was the secretary to the Government of India in the Ministry of Power, Heavy Industry and Chemicals and Petrochemicals, where he played a lead role in India's liberalization. Dr. Kapoor is currently on the board of directors of some of the largest companies in the private sector, as well as chairman of two prestigious foreign companies successfully operating in India. As chairman of the Festschrift Committee, Dr. Kapoor will now address the guests and present the Festschrift to Professor Dayal. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. D.V. Kapoor. Sir.
Dr. Rangarajan, Professor Ishwar Dayal, Professor Dogra, Professor Alak, friends, host gathering, that is the badge of 71 and also 77. Ladies and gentlemen, you will agree that to be associated with a person of distinction is always a matter of privilege. But this is much more so when the person of distinction is a teacher recognized by one and all for his human values as well as for his record of distinctive contributions in professional life, and that to spread over almost half a century. In the present situation, I am referring to, you understand that Professor Dayal is the man of distinction. And I am referring to myself like many of those present here and all others who are his admirers as the privileged ones. Considering his contributions in a variety of ways. It was only in the fitness of things that such a large number of his admirers, people from the management fraternity, academics, and also successful practicing managers who offered to be associated with Ishwar Dayal Festschrift Committee. I must, however, acknowledge that today's function would not have been possible but for the hard work, particularly put in by two persons, Professor Dogra and Professor Alak. This function, as we all know, is to pay our respects and good wishes from the committee for the dedicated and extensive work, research work, put in by these two persons in the name of, in all what Professor Dayal has done during the last 50 years. Personally, I was not so fortunate as 71 or 77 to have known Professor Dayal. I came to know him only in 1980 when he took over as the first full-time director of IIM Lucknow. And I happened to be one of the members of the board of management of that institute. But I was certainly, in the very first few meetings, so impressed by his ideas, not only on management profession, but more so on management of management education.
It's handing over the Festschrift to Dr. Kapoor. Thank you, Dr. Kapoor. It is indeed a moment of honor, emotion, and celebration for all of us who join in celebrating this moment of glory with Professor Dayal. This is an initiative to honor teachers. Professor Vinay Olak will now say a few words on this initiative. Let me say a few things about Vinay Olak for all those who don't know much about him. The batch will know him very well. Vinay is an electronic engineer from the IIT and an active member from the IIMA batch of 1971. In fact, he claims that every member of this batch is very active. He held senior positions in ISRO, Bureau of Public Enterprises, Ministry of Finance, and CMC, and he has been an academic since 1994. He's now a professor in the field of strategic management and business ethics. He was also a research affiliate in Harvard. Vinay, along with Professor Dogra, has played an active role in making this event possible. I consider him a valued colleague and a trusted friend. Friends, presenting Vinay Olak.
Dr. Rangarajan, Professor Ishwar Dayal, and Dr. D.V. Kapoor, and all the those who are present. I'm here to share with the genesis of the idea and its culmination in today's function. I'm presenting this under three headings: one, event; second, spirit; and the third, the journey, where we do go from here. Event. The idea of Festschrift originally was tossed by Dr. Tariq, our librarian colleague, but was picked up and incubated by Dr. Dogra. Our first hurdle was Professor Dayal himself, who brushed it aside as a waste of time. But response of IIMA alumni was so strong that he later on relented and allowed these to us to go ahead. The Festschrift, the German word, means celebration publication. It is supposed to honor an academic. It contains original contribution by students, colleagues of the colleagues to academics to be honored, essays, etc. The contents of exploration and management thought, a Festschrift in honor of Professor Dayal, have been conceptualized based on international norms. A study has been done about all the Festschrifts published in the world, and whatever is included in this is based on the international norms. It forced me to introspect the impact of Professor Dayal made on us. I had myself become a management teacher in mid-90s, thinking that it could be quite easy for an IIT and IIM background person to become a teacher. However, I found it very difficult to sustain the interests of younger generations and yet impart them relevant knowledge and skills incorporating our industry experience, insights and learnings. The biggest lesson I learned from Professor Dayal was that a teacher has to be a learner first and learner always. And that is why even at the age of 80 plus, Professor Dayal is so sharp, works so hard, and still is so strict as he always been, uncompromising on academic excellence, industry relevance, and intellectual integrity. It is mainly because of his invitations and encouragements that my classmates of 1971 batch, IMA, has so readily agreed to recycle what they have learned into academics by sparing their valuable time for my students.
Thank you, Vinay. Your words were very well appreciated. The event, the spirit, the journey, the road ahead, a concept which has been created and been initiated today to go on and bring about great excellence. Thank you, Vinay. This Festschrift, I would now like to invite Sunil to say a few words.
Thank you very much. Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. C. Rangarajan, Dr. D. V. Kapoor, Professor Dayal, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. In fact, Dr. D. V. Kapoor started very aptly by saying that to be associated with Professor Dayal in any manner, be a student, colleague, or whatever, it's always a great privilege. And I think, to me, it sounds the same way, sir. To be associated with him and publish his work, it was a matter of great pride for me and a privilege to me. Well, it all started one fine morning when I got a call from Professor Deepak Dogra, and he appraised me of the kind of work that he had undertaken, the massive work of getting some of the works of Professor Dayal into 6 volumes. The very fact that it was the collected works of Professor Dayal and it was coming in multi-volumes and a management set, I was left hardly with any other choice. And I immediately consented to partner Dr. Dogra and Professor Olak for this work. This was more so since I had heard of Professor Dayal during my stint with DCM Toyota for over 9 years, when he was also the chairman of DCM Limited. Okay, just to give you a brief idea about what Annie Books India is all about, we started a decade ago with the objective to distribute foreign books in India. Now, over the years, we have more than 60 publishers from across the globe for whom we distribute in India. A few years ago, we started a special drive to make available some of the foreign books which were prohibitively expensive to buy for the Indian students. And today we have in our kitty something like more than 400 books which we have either reprinted or the publishers have given us Indian prints here. In addition to that, we were also striving to start our own publishing. But we had just one single objective in mind, and that was quality. While taking on this project also, I knew that in terms of content, it would be perhaps second to none in the world. And now the onus was on me to make sure that whatever content is coming to me, it is produced and presented in a way that it is second to none in the world again. I have tried to do my bit. I have tried to put in the best possible production, and it will now be up to you all to decide whether we have been successful in this endeavor or not.
We now move to the next part of our program, where, ladies and gentlemen, we are honored, we'd like to state our honor, in to have in our presence Dr. C. Rangarajan, Chairman, Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister, who has graciously accepted the invitation to release the 6 volumes titled Ishwar Dayal on Management. Sir, I was fortunate to be your student of economics at the IMA. I won't share what grade I got. And I'm so happy to welcome you here. Dr. Rangarajan is the recipient of the prestigious Padma Vibhushan and also has been presented the award for outstanding leadership by the Wharton India Economic Forum, University of Pennsylvania. The several important positions held by Dr. Rangarajan, including being Governor of Reserve Bank of India and Governor of Andhra Pradesh, are well known to all. Sir, I must add, your students have always appreciated how you always give them time, even when you hold such important positions. Dr. Rangarajan was also Chairman, 12th Finance Commission, and member of the Planning Commission. An inspiring teacher and academician, Dr. Rangarajan has taught at the Wharton School of Finance and Commerce, University of Pennsylvania, and the Graduate School of Business Administration, NYU. He has also taught at leading educational institutions in India, including the Indian Statistical Institute, Loyola College at Chennai, and for over a decade at the Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad. Dr. Rangarajan has co-authored several books. Dr. Rangarajan will shortly be releasing the 6 volumes, Ishwar Dayal on Management, edited by Deepak Dogra. These volumes are the thoughts of the maestro in the field of management in terms of organization and administration, organization development and change, behavioral science applications, education and training, human resources in organizations, and public administration. The series will be a resource to both corporates and educational institutions. Friends, please join me in welcoming Dr. Rangarajan and requesting him to release the 6 volumes, Ishwar Dayal on Management. And sir, may we request you to release these volumes and address the audience. A series of 6 volumes.
Okay, all right. Excuse me.
Thank you, sir. May we request Dr. Rangarajan to say a few words? Sir, you could say it here.
Professor Ishwar Dayal, Dr. Kapoor, and friends, young and not so young, but youthful. It's a great pleasure to be here with you all this evening. I'm also delighted to see old friends and colleagues at this place. We have assembled here today, this evening, to felicitate Professor Ishwar Dayal, who is not only a doyen, but an architect of the management education system in our country. He is one of those who gave shape to management education as it has evolved in our country. I met him first in 1968 when I joined the Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad. My discipline is different from his, but we had many occasions to meet, interact, and discuss about the economy and about economic management. Of course, we interacted on issues facing the Institute itself. Professor Ishwar Dayal has for more than four decades dominated the world of management education in this country as a colossus, as a pace setter, and as a role model. In the early 1960s, management education was still in its infancy. It was given to Professor Ishwar Dayal and some other colleagues to give the contour and content to management education in this country. He did this as a teacher, as an institution builder, and as a researcher. What is it that distinguishes management education from other disciplines? I think the major contribution of management education in this country has been to introduce a system or a branch of a study of a system which is so different from others, in the sense this is the only field in which students who have gone through the program were trained to become professionals. It is a practical, the practice of management, which was added to the theory of management, which has essentially distinguished management education from the way in which we teach other disciplines in our country. It is an important thing. In fact, it has revolutionized, so to say, the thinking of the people. Today we talk a great deal about decision making. This term was not very much known in this country, let's say before the 1960s. That is, to look at a problem, to look at the alternatives, to make a choice as which is the most efficient of all of this, is a method of solving the problem. It is this that management education has contributed to the thinking in this country. We have in Ishwar Dayal an outstanding teacher, a dedicated researcher, and a great institution builder. I join all of you in wishing Ishwar Dayal many more years of productive life so that this great nation can gain from his wisdom. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We appreciate your thoughts and your oratory skills. We've always been spellbound listening to you. I remember that in the past too. With all humility, I would like to add to what you were saying about Professor Ishwar Dayal in terms of one of the abilities I've seen him in, which is his total understanding of being able to put himself in the shoes of the youngest teenager in our country today. He is able to keep up with the times and in fact stay ahead of his times and think totally. I'm sure that many of you have had interesting experiences with Professor Dayal. We now invite you to come forward and share these experiences. Our young ones, Omkar and Yogesh, will be having the mics. Please do come here, introduce yourselves, and let's have a small session where we listen to each other in terms of our experiences with Professor Ishwar Dayal.
1971 batch. We were fortunate, sir, in a way that when we were management students, there were few management institutes and we had outstanding faculty. And today we have with us the faculty members who were decidedly amongst the best. So we are so happy to, you know, to see Professor Dayal and Dr. Rangarajan together here. See, Professor Dayal's classes, you know, were very interesting. He was very measured in his tone, in his choice of words, and therefore one had to be extremely attentive to pick up the right message, because he was not repetitive. He was very, very about his words and the meaning. Contributed a lot on the macro aspect of the management education, but I would like to share with you a small incident where it impacted me personally a lot. Sir, you had offered a course in OB in which you had asked us to write about our life story, my own life story. And then you had taken that as an assignment and it was graded. When this, I got my assignment back, I would share my grades. It was a D. Now, I was quite, you know, shocked. I thought that I had narrated whole of my life story till then, very honestly and fairly clearly. So I went to Professor Dayal. He said, what did I miss out? What did I not do? He said, sit down, Bhuvan, I'll tell you. I think you don't understand yourself well enough. I said, what does that mean, sir? He said, look, again very measured, he said, look, in management, it is not important what is correct. It is more important what gets agreed upon. Number two, in order to influence people, you ought to understand them. Understand their feelings. And in order to understand their feelings, first you ought to understand yourself, your own feelings. And in your life story, I see a nice narration of events, but I don't see your feelings in it. And that is why, as far as I'm concerned, I see this as an incomplete story. And sir?
Would anyone else like to come and speak? Yes, sir, please.
I am Dr. N.L. Verma. I have studied under both the great teachers that we are sitting opposite them. In one instance, I had taken, of course, OB area case courses, and Professor Ishwar Dayal was my teacher. So in one particular session, a case was given to us. We were only four people in that organizational development class. And we thought somebody else would have read the case, somebody else would have read the case, and we all the four had not read the case. So Professor Ishwar Dayal came and asked, so let us discuss. Everybody looked down, somebody else will start talking, somebody else will start talking. And he asked one after another, have you read the case? He said, no. All the four said, no, no, no. So he said, okay, we'll meet next time. Just class was ended. I still feel if he had scolded us, if he has told us that, look, you cannot take things lightly, you have got to read and then come prepared. Mr. Shinai and myself went to him to bid goodbye. Then we said, okay, sir, let us have some parting advices. Of course, he gave some advices. And fortunately for me, I had some paper. I jotted down all that he said. And believe me, those papers are still with me. That is now 35 years back. Papers have gone old, and I must have scanned through those papers at least 100 times. And particularly whenever I used to go for interviews, I read those notes and then went for the interview. That is why I say, sir, that being your student had been a greater qualification for me than any other three post graduation and doctorate and all that thing. Thank you so much.
My name is Nagendra Singh. I'm not sharing my feelings and experience as a typical classroom student because I don't belong to that bash, though that was the time I was working in IIM. I had heard of the great guru from his publication from different sources. And it was the first time in my life when he returned back to India, I rediscovered him at Lucknow, where I was heading an institution of entrepreneurship development. And I was going through my own traumatic insights of how to deal with the world. And I was looking for a support in a location, a person who can be not only a professional guru and support in managing the board, but also a person who can inspire as to how to deal with the relationships, how to deal with the structures. As a teacher, first time in my ability and my inability, I saw him, a great source of strength. But that was just a beginning. When I left that place and I started interacting with him at different point of time, every moment of seminars or a program that I had attended, I found almost getting a new insight of whatever he said. I thought he's repeating. But when I sat for half an hour, suddenly I thought, he's saying something different. Though the theme was the same, the topic was the same, but today he's saying with a different insight. And that was a rediscovery for me as a teacher, as a learner, that how a teacher, though it appears on the face of it that he's talking about a theme of institution development, he's talking about almost caption is the same, but every moment a new experience of his life adding a value to me as a learner, to me as a listener. And as a person, wherever I met him in my struggle of building an Indian Society for Applied Behavioral Science as a president or any other occasions, I saw him giving a completely face.
Presently at Lal Bahadur Shastri Institute of Management, Delhi. Professor Dahl hired me at IIM Lucknow, and I just thought I'll take this opportunity in joining one and everyone in this hall in expressing our feelings the way they have been very meticulously put up before this August gathering. She said it's the last word. I can't claim, I can't even think of my word being the last word in a galaxy of this kind. But believe me, sir, the way you try to develop that institution in terms of the values, the niceties of working in that institution, 90%, I think Professor Devi Singh, who is heading that institute now, will agree with me and all of us here, those kinds of things are there in place. What it means, it's not just devising and designing ways and means, but devising and designing those means from the bottom of the heart is what has left that kind of an everlasting impression in one and everyone at that institute. Whether it is related to personal activities, official activities, academics, interaction with industry. Believe me, I joined one of the colleagues who just mentioned, you know, we started one program when we were not even in existence for training these IAS officers of 15 years experience. 40 of them having gathered in a place which we didn't own, it was just a rented premises. So they were late by a minute, and Professor Dahl did not conduct the class. And there was a great learning for all of us and those kind of people, I'm sure some of them will be here, what he meant by when he was talking of business in the real sense of the term.
I share my experience, but I'll say how you influence me in every day of my life. When I see you as a role model and when I see 6 books here and I look at it and it inspired me to write. I had the opportunity of asking him to write a review of my book, and you know, I have always taken from you, I have not given anything, so that's one thing. And the other thing is, when I look at you as institutions building, you know, I get a faith in Indian humanity that there are people who are very honest and who are contributing and without expecting anything in return. And, you know, I get a lot of satisfaction in this modern world where we see a lot of corruption and all those kind of things. And I feel very secure. And when I look at you, I say, oh, yeah, I would like to be like that. And I don't know, how will I give back?
You have touched the lives of not only this group, but to management development in India, both in the areas of academics and management consultancy. Your years at the Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad, Calcutta and Lucknow, Indian Institute of Public Administration, and when you were the Dean of the International Management Institute, New Delhi, have all contributed to making management in India more enlightened and professional. Your corporate life has been rich when you held senior management positions in Alembic Chemical and Pharmaceuticals Company, Philips India, Metal Box, and consulted with a host of Indian industry. We invite you to share your thoughts and feelings and address this group who has so affectionately come together to honor you. Professor Ishwar Dayal, let's give him a standing ovation first.
Dr. Rangarajan, Professor Deepak Dogra, Professor Vinay Olive, Mrs. Saxena, and Freda. It is difficult for me, friends, it is difficult for me to find words to thank you for the honor. I seriously doubt that I have done anything very different from many others, but I am lucky to have appreciative friends and well-wishers like you. I am indeed grateful. Like some others, I wandered into teaching without ever planning to do so. I was nominated by my... I thought it was polite conversation and let it pass. It was, however, followed up by Professor Tom Hill, who was leader of MIT team at IIM, and Katie Chandy. It took me 8 to 10 months to decide to make the shift. I was not entirely sure about the changeover, but soon after I joined, people like Douglas McGregor, Peter King, Warren Bennis, and others gave me new understanding of the job, and I began to recognize that a teaching job is in fact a commitment to learning, experimenting, and attempting to know on one's own and from others. I began to recognize that the excitement of learning and sharing ideas in fact defines the job. I am indeed grateful to many colleagues, friends, students, and companies which offered such scope for learning and experimenting to understand why and how things happen. It has been my good fortune to move to many places and many institutions. I did this for the newness of the situation, because that is what I thought would give me the opportunity to understand how one situation differs from another, and what processes contribute to their being different. Knowledge is neither right nor wrong. Cumulatively, it gives a deeper understanding of the reality around us. One generation or a group adds on to what may seem conclusive at some stage. Some ideas live longer than others and have greater contribution to knowledge. Some provide a foundation for new development. I believe that the logic that governs business decision making belongs to the last category. By and large, business operates on the binary logic of the Greek philosopher Aristotle. As you know, this logic espouses three laws which are basic to logical thought. One, the law of identity, A is A. Second, the law of contradictions, A cannot be both A and not A. And third, the law of excluded middle, A must be A or not A. The Eastern logic, especially the Chinese and the Buddhist, is based on a continuum. Personally, I see these notions as basic to the Western and the Eastern orientation. The Aristotelian logic is based on the proposition of either or, either something is white or not white. While much of Eastern logic is based on a continuum, that is, there are gray areas of many shades between the two points, and what could be best be described as intuitive wisdom. In the West, this perspective is developing in somewhat broad terms as fuzzy logic. The globalization in business has brought in a greater many complexions, and in some ways are seen to be relative to the situation and the context. It is more difficult to incorporate this reality in teaching management than the notions based on binary logic. It is more difficult to teach what makes right seem not right in another context. The most direct impact of these changes is on teaching methodology and the teaching learning environment of the institution. In both these areas, we have to travel a long way in our teaching institutions and business organizations. Japanese organizations develop competences and understanding close to intuitive wisdom or soft assets among many managers through a highly effective system of apprenticeship. I believe these practices have great relevance for us in our country. Knowledge based on binary logic would have increasingly less relevance in business and life in a global village if that were to happen. In my own consulting work in organizations, I have tried to develop among managers the impact of emerging realities in decision making. But in educational programs, I suspect these realities are not reflected to the measure necessary. There are new challenges ahead for us, and also the excitement of evolving and sharing ways of managing the many shades of gray in our work and life. For me, the life of learning and experimenting has been most satisfying, and I am sure in my remaining active years it will continue to be so. Recognition for all of us is most valuable, and it becomes more so when it comes from friends and colleagues who have been strong contributors to the process of knowing and learning. I have not harbored the illusion of changing people's way of life, but I have immensely enjoyed working with people who wanted to do this. I would like to conclude my thank you to all of you by relating a story that I read recently. Some of you may be also familiar with it. One scientist was strolling along the beach, he noticed a young man picking up something from the ocean and hurling it back into the ocean. It was so rhythmic that it looked like a well-choreographed dance. The scientist approaching him asked, "What are you doing?" The young person replied, "Throwing shellfish into the ocean. The surf is up and the tide is going out. If I don't throw them back, they will die." "Son," said the scientist, "don't you realize there are miles and miles of beach and thousands of shellfish? You can't probably make a difference." After listening politely, the boy bent down, picked up another shellfish, and threw it back into the surf. Then, smiling at the scientist, he said, "It made a difference to that one." We may not be able to change the world, but we can help some find their way in life. Thank you, and my special thanks to the members of the class of 1971, and to Dr. Dogra and Ola, who have worked hard to wade through piles of papers to bring out the collection of these volumes. I will always remember them with great affection. May God bless them to achieve what they value most. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Deya. I request the senior-most member of the batch of 1971, Commander Shenoy, he looks the youngest, to present a memento to Professor Ishwar Deya.
Commander Shenoy, Commander Shenoy's nickname. I was garrison engineer. I was garrison engineer 35 years when I went to IM. Naturally, everybody wanted to know why is there something loose in your head. You see? I went to IM because, you see, I am a civil engineer. I was seeing what you call decaying ethics, which was creeping into services also. Services were really neater, you see. Before me, before independence, Britishers were very careful to only induct people with integrity and also a status in the society. Those were the people who were giving it.
Thank you, Commander. Before we continue this celebration with dinner, may I request Professor Dogra to say the vote of thanks. Professor Dogra has been backstage orchestrating this event. A true researcher, he has edited these volumes in a record time. In fact, he's reputed for his hard work and ability to show very quick results. Dr. Dogra is a professor in knowledge management and business strategy. Friends, please give Dr. Dogra a hand. Dr. Dogra.
His Excellency Dr. C. Rangarajan, respected Dr. Kapoor, Professor Dyal, Professor Olan, distinguished academics, alumni of IMA, my dear colleagues, friends, ladies and gentlemen. I have the good fortune of having the opportunity of standing here at this podium, which is being adored by the galaxy of eminent persons. Well, I have the very pleasant task of proposing the vote of thanks to all of you for making this function to happen. Dr. D.V. Kapoor is a beacon for the corporate world, and his gracious presence here has boosted our morale tremendously. I thank you, sir, for your very kind presence, your pieces of wisdom, and for your kind gesture of releasing the Festschrift copy. Thank you, sir. Dr. Rangarajan's iconic stature is as emulative in academics as it is in the administration. We thank you, sir, for sparing your most valuable time. Sir, your very presence here is rejuvenating enough for us to rededicate ourselves to the service of the nation in whatever humble way we can. Thank you once again, sir, for releasing the management volume of Professor Dyal. Professor Dyal, sir, your wandering into teaching has done wonders to many who have in turn done wonders in the academics and administration and consulting areas. Thank you, sir, for this and many others benevolences you have bestowed upon us. I owe my great gratitude to all those who eminent persons who have contributed their thoughts for the Festschrift. It's a coveted treasure that all these contributors have splendidly generated. My very grateful thank to all you. I extend my very special thank to you, Professor Olak, Professor S.K. Kapoor, for being by my side through this project and extending your broad shoulders to enable me to shift some responsibilities onto them. This would not have seen the light of the day if your ever available help was not there. Thank you. My very special thanks go to all the IMA 1971 batch alumni who were very spontaneous to our call to this festival. A very big thanks to all you there, wherever you are. Any books? In fact, I recollect numerous occasions when I went beyond the reasonables to demand the proofs, designs, fonts, graphics, and the likes to which they remained always affirmative and positive. Particularly Kamal, but for their expeditious handling of the printing and publication, we would not have been able to organize this function in the month of August this year. Thanks, Annie, for this help. I shall be failing my duty if I do not mention about the tireless effort made by my other colleagues, particularly Frida, Keval Soni, Omkar, Yogesh, to name few, for their valuable contributions. Naming them individuals is being dispensed with by me here. Please accept my heartfelt thanks, you all. It's my very pleasant duty to thank the print and visual media. Last but not the least, I thank you all, ladies and gentlemen, friends and colleagues, for your having come to grace the occasion and making it a memorable one. I sincerely hope that the initiative that the IMA 1971 batch alumni have taken shall be followed up by many more alumni and the never-ending chain of this parampara gets going. Thank you, one all. Please join for the dinner on the lawns outside. Thank you very much.